Hi everyone, I'm Sireni and welcome to the Crazy Journal. Today in this video, we shall discuss about how to become an accountant here in Australia, as in what to study, what is the salary expectations, and what is the experience you need to accumulate to be a successful accountant, and so on and so forth. Do watch this video till the end because you are going to miss out some important information if you don't watch. So without any further ado, let's get started. Okay, so to begin with, let's discuss about what to study. Accountants generally provide taxation and financial help to all the organizations, let it be small business or huge businesses. So accountants need to be really good with maths, right? There are three regulating bodies surrounding the accounting field here in Australia: CA, CPA and IPA, and all three of them play an important role to provide accounting services and to regulate accounting services here in Australia. CA is nothing but chartered accountants, and PA is nothing but, which is IPA, is nothing but public accountants. In order to qualify for CA and CPA, you should be able to finish your undergrad, which is bachelor's, with a major in accounting. And that is really important. Finishing bachelor's will help you qualify to become a CA or CPA. But for IPA, it is slightly different. If you would want to get qualified for IPA, you should be able to at least pursue diploma course or advanced diploma in accounting. So to sum it up, for CA and CPA, you need at least have undergrad, which is bachelor's. But for IPA, you can go ahead with diploma and advanced diploma. Now that being said, some of the huge universities here in Australia, such as Deakin, Monash, Swinburne, Latrobe, UTS and a lot more universities, are offering these courses. Now for IPA, wherein you need to finish your diploma and advanced diploma, you can get that done in any college or any TAFE offering institutions. But for bachelor's, if you would want to go ahead with bachelor's and then master's and so on, so you have large universities offering these courses. Now let's talk about the structure. For CA, you need at least 18 months to 2 years to finish the complete course, because you also have a capstone to finish. Now that being said, for CA you don't have any electives. For CA, you do not have any options to select electives, so pretty much everyone will be studying the same. With CPA, you study 4 subjects plus 2 electives. Those 2 electives can be of any specialization that you would want to do in the accounting field, or I'm not sure what else would be in the electives, but for CPA, you need to study 4 subjects plus 2 electives. With IPA, unlike CA and CPA, you need to study 6 standard subjects, and that's not like how CA and CPA works, right? Some of these subjects include topics like taxation, business ethics, and some of the subjects will be those that you've studied back in university or something that you haven't studied in university as well. But you should go and pursue at least 6 standard subjects, and that's the requirement. Now, once you finish your studies, it is really important for you to become a member of either of these three bodies, which is CA, CPA and IPA, right? So in order to become a member of at least one of these bodies, you need to have a relevant experience, and that's called as mentored experience. For CA, CPA and IPA, you have different mentored experience requirements, and they are as follows. For CA and CPA, you need to have 36 months of mentored experience, and once that is done, you want to have your mentor to sign off some papers, wherein they tell you, they tell when they sign, it means that you are equipped with great accounting skills plus some soft skills, such that you can manage and you can work in a great corporate environment. So 36 months of mentored experience is really important. But with IPA, it is not 36 months of experience. With IPA, as I've been doing my research, they haven't specified a certain period of mentored experience, but mentored experience is really important, but it is not sure of how many months you need to have this mentored experience. Now that being said, for these mentor experience, no university or no one is basically going to help you out. It is you who is going to go and search for a mentor, and you need to convince them so that you know you can work under them and get the mentor experience, because 36 months is a long time. So once you finish your studies and once you finish your mentor experience, you will be out and about in the real world working as an accountant or assistant accountant. So the salary that you can expect for accountants, assistant accountants, and basically your junior accountant in the, you know, in the starting stages of your career is basically anywhere from $65,000 to $75,000. But eventually, as you gain experience and work in some great reputable organizations, your pay, your package would get hiked up based on your skills, the organization, and the amount of work and experience you have gathered in total. I hope this video was quite helpful and it has given you an overview of how to be an accountant in Australia. Do leave out great comments and also tell me what other occupations you would want to watch in the next videos of this particular series, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye!